This year, Ms. Adams' fifth grade classroom, we learned about adding, subtracting, fractions. All right, class, what is one important rule about adding and subtracting fractions?
Finding the common denominator.
And 1/3 plus 2/3 equals 1/2.
1/8 plus 1/4 equals 3/8.
8/16 minus 2/4 equals 0.
2/6 plus 2/4 equals 5/6.
8/16 minus 2/8 equals 1/4.
This year in Ms. Abbott's fifth grade class, we learned about area.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
There's length, there's width. You multiply it. When you mess with the best, you get, boom, area.
Length
times width
equals area.
Area.
Area!
This year in Ms. Abbott's class, we learned about benchmark fractions. And this is my song.
Benchmark fractions, benchmark fractions, benchmark fractions. Dun 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 dun. Benchmark fractions.
Wi-Fi fractions.
This year, Ms. Abbott's class, we learned about coordinate grids.
1, 2, 3.
I believe we can plot. I believe we can place a dot. We put it on the X or Y. Then we go fly, fly, fly.
Goodbye.
This year in Ms. Abbott's class, we learned how to divide fractions.
When you're dividing fractions, you just flip it.
And then change your division into multiplication.
And then do top times top, bottom times bottom.
And then you will find your answer.
Just flip it!
Ow!
This year in Ms. Abbott's class, we learned about dividing decimals. Turn the number in a hole, go left to right to make it roll. Don't forget to divide, check your work to see if it's all right.
This year in Ms. Abbott's class, we learn about exponents.
Wake up in the morning, then we multiply. Then we do 5 times 5 equals 25. Then you know 5 is a base and 2 the exponent. Drop your pencil because I know you'll be a pro at this.
This year, Ms. Abbott's fifth grade class will learn about improper fractions. Improper fractions have the bigger number on the top and the little number on the bottom. You have to take the bigger number and divide it by the little number to get your answer.
Yay!
This year in Ms. Abbott's fifth grade classroom, we learned about metric units. And we memorized this by King Henry died by drinking chocolate milk. The K is for kilo. The H is for hecta, the D is for deca, the B is for base, the D is for deca, C is for centa, and the M is for milla.
This year in Ms. Abbott's class, we learned how to multiply whole numbers.
M-U-L-T-I-P-L-Y, I find things that nobody else finds.
Make sure you line up the numbers.
M-U-L-T-I-P-L-Y, I find things that nobody else finds.
Don't forget to put in your placeholders.
M-U-L-T-I-P-L-Y, I find things that nobody else finds.
Add the numbers to get the product.
M-U-L-T-I-P-L-Y, I find things that nobody else finds.
Don't forget to check your work.
This year in Miss Abbott's fifth grade class, we learned about multiplying decimals. Walk in this classroom and the students looking at me. School clothes on and my math book is open. Multiplying decimals, multiplying decimals. Okay, now we're about to get started. Write down the problem. Don't line up the values. Now multiply, don't stop, A.
Do it.
Add up the numbers from the right of the decimal, A. Do it for both rows, A. Then move your decimal to the left of the product, A. Bam, here's your product.
This year in Ms. Abbott's fifth grade class, we learned about multiplying fractions.
My name is Garcia, and you know what I got?
What do you got?
I gotta multiply fractions a lot.
A lot of what?
Top times tops and bottom times bottoms.
Uh-huh.
We're gonna multiply fractions with you.
Fractions with you. Uh-huh, it's true.
It's totally true.
This year, Ms. Abbott's class, we learned about perimeter.
You're about to learn about perimeter.
Perimeter.
It's in the outside of the shape.
Outside of the shape. You add up all the sides.
Equals perimeter.
Perimeter.
This year in Ms. Abbott's fifth grade class, we learned about quadrilaterals.
I'm waking up to ash and dust. I wipe my brow and sweat my dust. I'm made of four sides, 360 on the inside. I'm checking out the prison bus. This is it, the quadrilaterals. Whoa.
This year in Ms. Abbott's class, we learned about triangles.
Guys, can you help me? I don't know how a triangle can have an acute, right, or obtuse angle.
Well, a triangle can have an acute angle if the angles are less than 90 degrees.
It could be a right angle if it's exactly 90 degrees.
A triangle with obtuse angle is greater than 90 degrees.
Thanks, guys.
This year, Ms. Abbott's class, we learned about variables.
I don't get this.
Me neither.
We're just gonna teach about a variable. A variable is just a letter that we number. We already got some variables from A to Z. We just want some help with our word. We got to talk to Tasha.
Yeah.
Variables.
This year in Ms. Abbott's fifth grade classroom, we learned about volume.
All you gotta do to find volume is
multiply
the length
times width
times height.
Volume.